When discussing habitable exoplanets, the one thing that always comes up is liquid surface water. There is a good reason for this. Life on Earth wouldn't exist without it, and it's a good bet that life in general can't exist without some kind of liquid solvent for the chemistry to occur. Water is the best and most abundant solvent in the universe, though there are other possibilities. But even water has its limits. And here are two scenarios, one real world and the other speculative, that illustrates the idea that having surface water can go horribly wrong and result in bad consequences for life. The first is the exoplanet HD85512b, which at first glance looks like it might be a good candidate for liquid water and even life. In fact, when it was first discovered, it was considered among the best possible candidates for this. However, subsequent research has cast this very much in doubt, and instead now paints a picture of a world where having significant amounts of water might have been a liability rather than an advantage. This planet is a super-Earth, about 3.6 times the mass of our own planet. It orbits a suitable star for life, a K-type star, which are thought to be possibly even better for the development of complex life than our own Sun. And it's rather close, at only 36 light-years away. This is a kind of planet that we may someday visit. At currently possible speeds, we could get a probe to this planet in a few hundred thousand years. Now this may seem like a painfully long time, but so long as we don't destroy ourselves and end our branching out into the universe with colonies, then we have nothing but time on our hands. In fact, we have billions, billions of years worth of time. A few hundred thousand years is a blink of an eye in that context, especially if your species is sufficiently technologically advanced as to be immortal, or nearly so. Having said that, HD85512b may not be a world worth going to at all, despite being thought to be rocky. And the reason is water. This exoplanet lies just inside its star's habitable zone. As it orbits, it sort of skirts in and out of the inner edge of the zone. This means that this world is warm enough for liquid water, at least initially, and may have had oceans in its early history. The system is also old enough for life to have evolved at an estimated 5.61 billion years, which, if we're any indication, is ample time to develop an intelligent species. However, the fact that it sits on the inner edge of the zone is where the problem lies. That makes it just warm enough on this world to have evaporated any water on the surface. Water vapor is an efficient greenhouse gas, and as such, would have made the problem worse. Eventually, a very hot desert planet with a steamy high water vapor atmosphere would have resulted. But that period early in the history of HD85512b illustrates the second problem with water. It's thought that this world would have had a lot of water, enough to where it had little to no land. Too much water and no land would tend to lock life in. So, even if it had been stable and developed life, that life would be oceanic, with no adaptation for land. This is no problem for developing intelligence, as our own ocean is full of smart animals. But it's a problem for developing a civilization. However, that is a topic for a future video. Thank you so much for listening. I've been Eleanor Davenport, in for John Michael Godier, who is currently being attacked by microbes, and will be back just as soon as his voice is. Be sure to subscribe to the channel for regular, in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.